we have here, beginning with verse 3, a very interesting set of questions. In fact, there are 7 questions that are asked and answered, and these questions are quite logical and reveals what a matter-of-fact prophet Amos really was. This man got right down, friends, to the place where 2 + 2 = 4. He got right down where you and I live today. And here we find him dealing with certain great truths. And actually, as others have pointed out, what you have here, this man Amos, who was from the country, way down yonder in Tekoa, in the wilderness, he draws from his long experience down there these lessons in nature, in the natural world. And he learned something that a great many folk need to learn today that do not really know where a great many things come from. I never shall forget when my daughter was growing up here in Pasadena at her school, they took them out to a dairy. And she came home with the most exciting news that you've ever heard, friend. She told us that milk came from a cow. She thought that you got it over at the market, that you just reached in and took out a bottle or a paper carton of milk, and that's where it originated. It was an amazing fact. Well, this man, Amos, he's a countryman. He knows a great deal about nature, and it reveals he'd observed things. Now he's going to mention some of them as we go along. The first question is this. Can two walk together? Can two walk together? Yes. Except they be agreed. They can't go together if they're not in agreement. I watched a young couple the other day, haven't been married long, and they were walking down the street arm in arm, and all of a sudden, she turned around and stamped her little foot and started walking back toward their home, and he kept going. They weren't walking together. Something had happened. They'd had a disagreement. Probably one of their first fights, by the way. Can two walk together except they be agreed? Here is a cause and an effect. The cause is there must be agreement if you're to walk together with God. And the result will be if you're to walk with Him, there must be agreement. Now, that doesn't mean that God's going to come over and agree with you. You and I will have to come over and agree with Him. Someone has said that God rides triumphantly in His own chariot. And if you don't want to get under the wheels of those chariots, you better get aboard and ride. After all, God is carrying through His purpose in the world. You and I got here pretty late, you know. And frankly, we're not going to be here very long. So your will and my will, it will not prevail at all. I was very much interested in visiting in England those castles at Windsor Court, at Windsor Castle, Hampton Court, where Henry VIII, and I think of poor Henry VI, and I think of Richard II. Some of those boys made a trip to the Tower, lost their heads there. The very interesting thing is they had their way for a little while, Henry did, but nobody's paying attention about what Henry VIII thought or what he did. My friend, may I say to you that if you're going to walk with God, you're going to have to go His way. Now, let's keep moving. That's the first question, and it's a great principle that is put down here. How can two walk together except they be agreed?